And welcome back our dear viewers. Now it's time for our daily threat review for today, Monday the 20th of February 2017. And we are very much delighted to have with us in the studio our dear guest, Mr. Ayoub Mahmoud Ayoub, former Minister of Commercial. Hello.
Good morning to you and to the viewers.
Good morning, sir. And we'll start our press from Al Ahram. Enhancing international cooperation in combating terrorism. And the president says the Egyptian-American ties has a strategic nature. In his meeting with the delegation of the heads of the American Jewish organizations, the president says we are developing our economy while continuing our war on terrorism. And the American delegation praises the steps taken to improve the living standards in Egypt. Still with the same issue, and from Al Akhbar, we read its main banner in the meeting with the heads of the American Jewish organizations. Assisi says just and comprehensive peace achieves development in the region. And Assisi says we are moving steadily on the track of achieving development. And the members of the delegation say Egypt is the cornerstone of stability in the region and its role is vital. President Abdel Fattah al-Sisi asserted on the necessity of reaching a just and comprehensive solution to the Palestinian cause, which would end the Israeli-Palestinian conflict. President al-Sisi said that achieving peace in the region will pave the way for achieving economic and social development and will contribute to combating terrorism and eradicating terrorist organizations. President al-Sisi's statement came during a meeting with a delegation of the heads of the American Jewish organization, which was attended by the head of the intelligence, Khaled Fawzi. President spokesman Ali Youssef said that the president was keen on meeting with the different sects of the American society in order to bolster mutual communication and understanding of the nature of the challenges that face the region and means of facing them. Sir, what's your take on the meeting yesterday, which was held by President Abdel Fattah al-Sisi and the heads of the Jewish organizations?
It is an important meeting because the Jewish organizations and the Jewish lobby in the United States and in the Congress is quite influential, and we know that.
Indeed, of course.
So we cannot close the doors or the windows with all the segments of the American university. We have to speak to them all because this influence the decisions of the new administration. And we have every interest that we have a good contact with the administration and the good, let us say, I will not say lobbying, but rather let us explain our position as far as the Middle East crisis and the Palestinian issue is concerned. What is important is that the president stressed that the solution of the Palestinian issue is important for peace in the in the area and for stability in the area, and taking the terrorism in consideration and development of economic situation in Egypt in consideration also. So there are three main components of the dealings with the United States through this or that segment.
Indeed.
That is terrorism, economic development in Egypt, and Palestinian issue. There are many ways that we can tackle each of this one, and Egypt was very clear in clearly defining its decision as far its position as far as the Palestinian issue is concerned. It did not change, but rather we have to cope with the changes in the new administration in the United States.
Yes, and back to Al Ahram. And from the front page, we read the presidency says Egypt is exerting its utmost effort to reach a comprehensive and just solution to the Palestinian cause without any compromises. The presidency issued a statement on Sunday in response to the information tackled in a press report regarding the participation of President al-Sisi in a meeting with Jordan's King Abdullah, the Israeli Prime Minister, and the former U.S. Secretary of State John Kerry in Aqaba last year. Presidential spokesman Ambassador Ali Youssef said that Egypt is exerting its utmost effort in order to reach a just and lasting solution to the Palestinian cause based on the two-state solutions and the right of the Palestinians to establish their independent state on the borders of June 4, 1967, with East Jerusalem as its capital. And still with the same issue, but from Al Akhbar and from the front page, the presidency says Egypt is working hard to achieve a just and comprehensive solution to the Palestinian cause in response to false reports that have circulated regarding the participation of al-Sisi in Al Aqaba meeting. The presidency says Egypt is working hard to reach a just and comprehensive solution to the Palestinian cause. Mr. Ayoub, of course, we have been hearing this information, the false information about the meeting which took place last year. But a part of that, how we can find just solution to the Palestinian cause, which has been a real problem for the whole region for years now.
I think that to have the just peace and the consistent and continuous peace for the Middle East crisis, first step is the unity between the Arab countries.
Mm.
This is a must. And we have to go to
solid and united front.
That united front is the most important thing. What they are, the other party are doing, try to divide the Arab countries between East and the West, pro and anti, and so on. So this is one united front is the first step. Second, the administration, U.S. administration, has to be convinced because they finance Israel. They finance. In many forms, whether military aid or financial aid or support in the United Nations and so on. So the United States, the new administration has to be convinced with the stability, the importance of stability in the Middle East for its own interest, for the United States interest. So the United States have to be convinced in every possible way, and we are doing that. When we find rumors or some press reports or false press reports here and there, they always do that to reach certain aims and goals. And we are clear in that respect. Egypt is beside the and supportive, quite supportive. I did not change its position towards the Palestinian issue. And when they say this or that, sometimes it is false press reports or balloons to test this or that. And we are familiar with that when it comes to the Israeli media and the Israeli leakage of WikiLeaks from the Israeli side.
Of course. And from Al Masri, اليوم we read its main banner. Egypt begins to promote the Dawa nuclear project next Saturday and the international conference, the first of its kind, to highlight the popular support and inviting the leaders of Dawa tribes to participate. Egypt is to begin promoting the Dawa nuclear project next Saturday. What's your take?
I am very pleased to read this news because we are lagging almost 30 years as far as the nuclear energy is concerned, and now we are putting it back. We are put back on, not only in the agenda but beginning implementing the agreement between President Sisi and President Putin as far as the nuclear power is concerned. We cannot lag anymore as far as nuclear power. It is a must. It is a must. It is there in Japan, in the United States, in France, all over the world. They are using nuclear power, and you have to commit, because one day we will not find petrol or gas all over the world. It will be depleted. It is a matter of time only. So we have to begin now. And when we say nuclear power, it means many Egyptian industries are involved. Not just nuclear power reactors. Many Egyptian industries and know-how is needed in that respect, beside the Russian know-how, of course. It is a big investment and a big sacrifice which you have to support to begin from now and not lag anymore as far as nuclear power is concerned.
And from Al-Ahram, and we read from its front page, the deputy of Salva Kiir says, "We have historic ties with Egypt and we appreciate the role of President Sisi." The vice president of South Sudan says to the paper, "South Sudan is the southern strategic depth of Egypt that highlights the strong ties between both countries. The South Sudanese official described the ties with Egypt as immortal and that the peoples of the two countries are linked with joint interest, history and traditions." Of course, the Egyptian-Sudanese relations are historic, as the deputy of Salva Kiir did say, on all fronts.
Yes. Why we say that? Because it's very important for all of us to be clear as far as our relations with South Sudan is concerned. There are always good and stable and fraternal relations with South Sudan, even when it was part of one Sudan, and now, because we know very well that the water passes by South Sudan, and there is Jongli Canal, which was devastated at some time during the civil war. So we paid the price of civil war in South Sudan. And now we have to cooperate, because there are a good number of South Sudanese in the universities, in the hospitals, in the several institutions, and we are having every interest technical know-how, transfer of technical know-how, economic cooperation, commercial relations, and all these are components of a vital bilateral relation with between Egypt and South Sudan, and luckily, and has always been good, or rather very good relations with South Sudan, who are our brothers and sisters in the South.
Yeah. And from Al-Akhbar front page, we read some financial news. The US dollar retreats and records 15 pounds and 70 piastres in the banks. The US dollar continues its decline and losses 20 piastres before the Egyptian pound. And the head of the Economic Committee at the House of Representatives says the prices will retreat in the coming months. Of course, we have seen a retreat for the US dollar before the Egyptian pound. It did reach 15 pounds and 70 piastres in some banks. And some experts are saying that we are going to witness more retreats in the coming days. So what's your take?
The US dollar price in Egyptian pounds 8.88 in November last year, just 4 months ago. Now it is 15.7, almost 80% higher. When the prices, my own opinion is that when the prices go up, they rarely come back down. So I hope that the prices will come back, will go down as far as the essential goods for the Egyptians are concerned. But in most cases, the prices go up and does not retreat in the same percentage as the US dollar to the Egyptian pound.
Mm. And from Al-Ahram and from the front page, the Tunisian president receives Shukri Mishal and Al-Ghinawi, a joint three-way statement regarding the Libyan crisis. Foreign Minister Samih Shukri attended a meeting of the foreign ministers of Libya's neighboring states in which the ministers of Tunisia and Algeria are participated. Foreign Ministry spokesman Ahmed Abu Zaid said the ministers discussed the talks that have been held between the three neighboring countries and the warring factions in Libya in order to reach a peaceful settlement for the crisis in the country. In his speech before the meeting, Shukri thanked Tunisian President Beji Qaed Sibsi for the efforts which he did exert in order to solve the crisis in Libya. Shukri stressed that there will be no alternative for a peaceful settlement in Libya and any foreign interference in the country would not be acceptable. Of course, yesterday, Foreign Minister Samih Shukri did travel to Tunisia to attend the meeting of the neighboring countries of Libya with the participation of the foreign ministers of Tunisia, Egypt, and Algeria, of course, and the heads of the different factions, the warring factions there. Are we going to witness a real solution on the ground? We want a peaceful and a real solution for the crisis in Libya.
There will be no solution for the Libyan crisis without the cooperation of these three neighboring countries, I see Egypt, Tunisia, and Algeria. With the new regime, we know that there are several factions, or two main factions, let us say, in Libya. The military solution cannot keep Libya alive. The only settlement can be through let's say consensus between the two main factions in the east and in the west, and with the support of the three countries to one solution. That is very important.
Of course,
we should not be siding with this faction or that faction. All the three countries that are, what is very important, that at some stage Algeria was at some position as far as the Tripoli government is concerned. Now they are coming to the consensus or the conclusion that they have to cooperate together so that Libya is kept as one entity and one integrity. The integrity of Libya should be kept.
Of course. The last item we have chosen for today comes from Al-Ahram. Trump establishes safe areas in Syria with the money of the Gulf. And in Florida, Trump talks about safe zones for the refugees that would be financed by the Gulf states. And a new draft of the executive order of the travel ban to be announced soon that would not prevent the holders of the green cards from entering the United States. Of course, we have been in that hassle of the seven countries which have been forbidden from entering or taking visas or the residents of these countries to enter the United States. How do you see this dilemma which was created by the Trump administration?
Yes, there are two parts of it. First, the creating a neutral zone in some place in Syria, and the Arab countries should pay for it, or Gulf countries should pay. It's exactly like the fence with the Mexico, which Mexico has to pay for, and Mexico, of course, will not pay for that. And now they are trying to find some way of. I think that it is a kind of division or establishing a no-fly zone in some place in Syria. This is not good for the integrity or the one country of Syria. It is very important. When it comes to the green card holders, now they are, we are coming back to reason, because many Americans who have green card holders and they are working in very reputable organizations from several countries. I know that from India, a good number of them have complained and demonstrated in several places.
It's very logical.
And this is how come that when we move, for example, some people working with this company and is going overseas for promotion of the American company, then he is forbidden from coming back to his own country and his own company.
Indeed.
So I think that they are coming back to reason, away from the election rhetoric and campaigns.
Of course, Mr. Ayoub Mahmoud Ayoub, former Minister of Commerce, always a pleasure to have you with us, and have a lovely morning, sir.
Thank you. Have a nice day.
Thank you, sir. And with that, our dear viewers, we come to the end of this edition of the Press Review for today. Now we'll go to a short break, and after that, we will be back to resume the segments of the Breakfast Show. So don't go away.